When promises were added to JavaScript, they promised a way out of callback hell, right? And then you see that, right? Even with promises, you can write very callback heavy code. I also call them like triangles of doom. Basically what we have here is a function that takes a list of IDs, calls each ID, calls an API call with the ID, and then like does something with that. We can break our servers if the list is too large here. What we need to do is to actually batch individual calls, break that array into smaller chunks, and then like batch it. Right? Typically, what generally people end up doing is to just add a lot of logic inside the same function. But what we will see today is to make sure we don't do that, and then have a cleaner way to write this. First step is to basically batch everything. You see two routines both do the same thing. The one on your left will have the same thing and reduce. The one on the right does the same thing with the for loop, classical for loop. We are breaking that large array into chunks of smaller 100 item ones. And if we use that function like that, it doesn't help because like all the calls still go almost at the same time. What we need to do is to essentially wrap each batch into a separate promise and then chain those promises together. And that way, each promise will wait. Each promise will wait for the previous one to finish, and then like you won't avoid. You'll basically avoid not killing your server. Too many negations. So there are two ways to do this. The one on the left side is essentially what we saw earlier, which we want to completely avoid. The other way to do the same thing is to imagine each step in the whole procedural thing as a step in a chain of events. Each batch returns the value of that current execution to the next batch, and then we have a bunch of those execution steps. So essentially, we want the right one. That's why it's on the right side. Right? So we'll pick that. Now we need to make that into a iterator. Right now, this is all like one line by line written, typed out by hand. We want to make that an iterator which works on arrays. This is basically similar to that. The initial value is an empty array. We are just resolving that promise, and then like we're iterating over the rest of the things, which we can do with a for loop or a reduce. Again, for loop on the right side, reduce on the left. This helps a lot. This is really good. We already have a way to do the sequence of events in a sequential steps. But let's see how easy it is to change this code. Let's add a delay between each of these steps. Now, instead of just wrapping the internal function with a set timeout, we'll actually write that inside an isolated function, separate from the whole thing. That function returns a promise, which resolves after 1 second, with whatever data that it got. So essentially, it acts as a pass-through, which resolves in 1 second. So to use that function, all we have to do is that, like one line of code change in existing code. If you see this and like think this is helpful, this really is, because we have a huge application where we made this kind of refactoring very recently, and it's been really helpful for us. The usage is like that. Now, all promises provide, the reason for this to work is basically because promises provide a very clean interface, and they provide a consistent API. Any promise that is wrapped with a value, asynchronous or synchronous, always returns another promise, and which can be changed together. So keep avoiding those callbacks and make sure that the triangles are flat. Thank you so much.